Welcome back, PC World fans, and welcome to PC World News. And this week is a packed one from Windows 11 CPU compatibility clarifications. Nintendo has a new console coming. GPU prices are on a decline, but shortages ensue. And a bit from the rumor mill has PC gamers concerned. Let's jump right into it, shall we? Want to know just what CPUs can officially run Windows 11? Well, Elena has the details in an article linked in the description below, so you don't have to worry about hearing me rattle off several generations of CPUs from both AMD and Intel. But this topic has been rather controversial and with a lot of mud in the water, so, well, we've been working hard at trying to keep things updated as the dust settles, and as of now, the list Elena has compiled is quite extensive. The Intel compatibility for Windows 11 dates back to around mid-2017 mark and no earlier. Think basically 8th generation onward. While AMD support dates back to 2018, so keep Zen Plus or 2nd generation Ryzen in mind for that side of the fence, but AMD has confirmed that all Ryzen processors support Secure Boot, SVM, and FTPM 2.0. This information does not change Microsoft's official compatibility list, however, in theory, 1st generation Ryzen CPUs would fit the published criteria for Windows 11, which highlights why further clarification of Windows 11's hardware requirements is a necessity at this point. Patch Tuesday is what we in the Windows PC community like to refer to as Microsoft's lovingly rolled out monthly updates, but they jumped the gun this past week and published it on Monday night. Why? Well, Print Nightmare exploit is to blame for that one. This one is so bad that even Windows 7, which has been dropped from public support for quite some time, even got an update. But what is Print Nightmare, you ask? Well, Print Nightmare attacks the Windows Print Spooler service, which runs by default. A remote code execution vulnerability exists within the Windows Print Spooler service and improperly performs privileged file operations. Microsoft's executive summary states an attacker who successfully exploited this vulnerability could run arbitrary code with system privileges. An attacker could then install programs, view, change, or delete data, or even create new accounts with full user rights. This is pretty serious stuff, as you could have woken up to find your computer was no longer yours and under complete control of a stranger rifling through your personal data. Pretty scary stuff, folks. Now, PC gamers and enthusiasts have always held a special place for Nintendo, and since the Switch launch, it has found itself at home as a great companion piece for those on the move. But after a few years since its launch, Nintendo is finally updating the Nintendo Switch to a larger 7-inch screen that is sporting the excellent OLED technology, along with enhanced audio and 64GB of internal storage. Oh, and the dock gets a physical Ethernet port. Now, when do we get the Super Switch, Nintendo? But back over into the PC world, in an article over at Barron's, Max Cherny interviewed CEO of AMD, Dr. Lisa Su, on how she's managing the company as well as the chip shortage. And I urge you to go give this entire interview a read, as it's quite informative. But the big takeaway for us PC enthusiasts is that she expects the chip supply chain to remain quite tight, even staying that way into 2022. Now that's a bummer for sure, but having some realistic expectations might temper people rather than just saying, sure, it'll be fine tomorrow, or maybe next quarter. But what about some good news for those hoping to get their hands on a shiny new graphics card? Well, it may not be new or shiny in the literal sense, but according to 3dcenter.org, there has been a drastic drop-off in retail prices for Radeon RX 6000 series, as well as the GeForce RTX 30 series. Admittedly, this is just in Germany, but I'm hopeful that this is just a sign of things to come, as we see many factors converging that appear to be setting up the cryptocurrency scene for a bear market. Sure, that wouldn't solve the shortages entirely, but it should free up allocation for those gamers out there trying desperately to get a modern graphics card. Now, speaking of modern graphics cards, what about those unreleased or even unannounced cards like the Radeon RX 6600 series that PowerColor teased us by slipping up and listing them on their website? Well, according to TechRadar and their various sources, the pricing of these cards could be a bit worrisome. If the expected performance, as we even touched on in this week's The Full Nerd, definitely go watch that if you haven't, is expected to be around the RX 5700 XT, then that's great, but the expected price tag is close to that of $399 mark, then we have basically getting an RX 5700 XT with support for mesh shaders, variable rate shading, and ray tracing. Not really that exciting overall, but it's not set in stone, so we'll have to wait to see what the future holds on this one. Well, folks, that's been it for this week's PC World News, and I hope you found it informative and maybe a little entertaining. Make sure you hit that thumbs up, and we thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe to PC World for more PC hardware coverage.